Anabaena. Anabaena is a cyanobacteria, or earlier called blue-green algae. This Anabaena, as the picture shows, it's a filamentous blue-green algae, just like other blue-green algae of Nostocalis order, that is Nostoc, this Anabaena. It is much more similar to the Nostoc, but a slightly different from other blue-green algae like Oscillatory. Hello friends, I am Ayantika, and in this video I will be discussing about the overview of Anabaena, its basic structure, its reproductive strategies, and its economic importance. So let's start the video. Before we start a video, there is a single question quiz. Neurotoxin, anatoxin A, degraded by which of the following factors? So, neurotoxins, this anatoxin A, it is a toxin produced by the cyanobloom. And you have to answer among the four options given. If you know the answer, you can write in the comment section, or if you don't know, then I will be giving the answer at the end of the video. So this Anabaena is composed of filament, unbranched filament of monilliform cells, that is bead-like cells. The structure of Anabaena and Nostoc is quite similar, that is the cell, each cell is bead-like or monilliform, and both these two genus have much enlarged cells called heterocysts and acinets. So these filamentous Nostoc and Anabaena, but main difference between Nostoc and Anabaena is that though both have filament, that is a trichome along with the mucilage, but Nostoc is mostly colonial and Anabaena is mostly solitary. Though under very rare circumstances, we can see the Anabaena to be occurring, many filaments of Anabaena occurring together in a mucilaginous mass, but mostly the Anabaena are found to occur solitarily. So this is the classification, that is, it belongs to division Cyanophyta, class Cyanophyceae, orders Nostocalis, family Nostocaceae, and genus Anabaena. So this is of cosmopolitan distribution, mostly aquatic, but in terrestrials, a few terrestrial habitat also, especially damp soil, Anabaena can be found. Most of the aquatic Anabaena species are freshwater. However, very few marine species can also be found. Normally Anabaena is microscopic, but under very rare circumstances, when a few filaments, they are enclosed together in the mass, they become macroscopic. Mostly it occurs as a single filament, organization is a single filament, and very rare condition, it is colonial. And the temperature tolerance for Anabaena is very high, that is, it occurs in hot springs with a temperature of 74 degrees C. And mostly hot water spring Anabaena belong to the genus Anabaena circinalis. And Anabaena, it is a cyanobacteria, which means that it can produce its own photoassimilate, that is, it can photosynthesize on its own. At the same time, it can fix nitrogen. So it can grow in oligotrophic water, that is, nutrient deficient water also. But one of the main limiting factor upon which the growth of the Anabaena depend is phosphorus. Anabina is a very common bloom forming species, and we know that in any cyanobloom, that is cyanoblooms are a gradual increase in the number of cyanobacteria in a water body. I have made a separate video about cyanoblooms, and I will be putting the link in the description box, but I'm not going to discuss what is cyanobloom in this video. Just I could say that Anabina, Microcystis, Cylindrospermopsis and Aphanozomelon are found together in the bloom. We should note that bloom is not composed, any cyanobloom is not composed of a single species, but a combination of many species, of which Microcystis, Aphanozomelon, Cylindrospermopsis and Anabina are quite common. And this bloom, cyanobacteria, they produce toxins, and these toxins are affect both human as well as animals. This is a very rare structure. We see that. Okay, let me point out. So this is the we see that the individual filaments of Anabina, they are embedded in this mass of gelatin. The gelatinous secretion in Anabina is not so copious as in Nostoc. In Anabina, we see that the monilliform cells are arranged in as a string of pearl with a few large cells, namely the acinete and the heterocyst. Now, all the somatic vegetative cells of the Anabina, they are responsible for the photosynthesis, and this acinete here, it is a resting spore, that is, it is used to tide over unfavorable condition, and on return of favorable condition, these acinete form an entire filament. Now these acinetes lie either next to or close to another type of cells, which are called heterocyst. In heterocyst, what happens is the nitrogen fixation, and as we know that for nitrogen fixation, the main enzyme nitrogenase is sensitive to oxygen. So in this heterocyst, there is an altered photosystems, that is, there is only photosystem 1 and no photosystem 2 inside the heterocyst. Thus we see that in Anabina, the photosynthesis and the nitrogen fixation, they are spatially separated, that is, photosynthesis is mainly in the somatic cells or the normal vegetative cells, and the nitrogen fixation occurs only in the heterocyst, where we do not have photosystem or even protein synthesis in the full. Nitrogen fixation, it takes place only in the heterocyst. Here is the picture we see of the filament of Anabina. We see that the monilliform vegetative cells and much larger acinetes and heterocysts. We know that most of the cyanobacteria, they are of filamentous nature, and here is the examples of few cyanobacteria. I have already made a video on Nostoc. Here is the colony of Nostoc, which has many filaments of Nostoc held within the mucilaginous matrix. But today I am discussing this Anabina, which occurs singly or loosely intertwined with each other, and I will be soon discussing in the next few videos about the oscillatoria. Here we note that the Nostoc and the Anabina, they are of almost of similar appearance, but in Oscillatoria and Arthrospora, we see that the cells, they are not monodiform, but they are cuboidal, and they do not have differentiation of the filament into vegetative cell, acinete and heterocyst. So these heterocysts and acinetes, they are found in Nostoc and Abena, but not Oscillatoria or Arthrospira. This is the example, typical example of any cyanobacteria. Here, the uppermost is the mucilaginous coating or gelatinous coating of glycolipids, and next to it or inner to it is the cell wall, which is much thick, and the cell wall of all the gram-negative bacteria and cyanobacteria, they are composed of four layers of wall, and inner to the cell wall, compound cell wall, that is from L4 to L1, that is from outward to inward, it is L4, L3, L2, L1, these are the four layers of the cell wall, and inside the cell wall, inner to the cell wall is the plasma membrane. This is the plasma membrane. We see that the thylakoids are arranged parallel to the plasma membrane. The entire cytoplasm of any cyanobacteria, or here we are discussing Anabaena, it is composed of outer colored part, that is the centroplasm, and the outer part is the chromoplasm, that is colored, that appears hyaline inner portion is called the centroplasm, which contains the circular DNA, RNA, and certain ribosomes. And so this, as we know that all the cyanobacteria are prokaryotic, that is, they do not have any membrane-bound organelles. So as because they do not have membrane-bound organelles, their nucleus is not membrane-bound. It is just an incipient nucleus with intertwined mass of DNA, and the DNA also do not have any histone proteins, just like the eukaryotes do. So it is just an incipient nucleus with DNA and a few RNA and ribosomes. And apart from that, there are also the gas vacuoles. These are actually not true gas vacuoles, as because they do not have any membrane bound structure, just like the gas vacuoles in eukaryote. The prokaryotic gas vacuole of the cyanobacteria composed of gas filled sacs, and sac is formed by protein rather than the protein lipid membrane. Here the gas vacuole is bounded by just protein layer, and the food reserve in Anabaena and any other cyanobacteria is cyanophycian starch and cyanophycin. Cyanophycin is a oligomer of few amino acids. It is a precursor, we can say that this is proteinaceous, and the mixophycin is of carbohydrate origin. So apart from this inclusions, that is granular inclusions like cyanophycin starch and cyanophycin and gas vacuoles, there is also polyphosphate crystals. We know that the Anabaena, phosphate plays an important role in its growth. So polyphosphate crystals can be found if it is found to be growing in the media that has that is rich in phosphorus. Otherwise, in normal media, the polyphosphate granules are not that abundant. And the thylakoids, it contains on its surface the pigments, that is the chlorophyll A, beta carotene, xanthophylls and phycobilins.
This
is the division of labors in the between the somatic cells and the heterocyst. We observe that the heterocyst has only PS1, and the PS2 and PS1 both are present in the vegetative cell. That is, in the vegetative cell, carbon dioxide absorbed and photoassimilate is made, which is made in the somatic cells, and this photoassimilate enters the heterocyst through the plasmodesmata in the polar nodule. This is the polar nodule, and this the nitrogen that is fixed by the heterocyst, nitrogen is fixed by the heterocyst in the ammonia form, later by the amino acid glutamine. Glutamine is transferred to the vegetative cell, where it is converted to other type of amino acids also. So we see this is a division of labor. Heterocyst mainly absorbs the reduction of nitrogen, and the vegetative cell, it has the photosynthesis, and they are interdependent, the heterocyst and the vegetative cell. And transfer occurs through this plasmodesmatal connection between the vegetative and the heterocyst cells, and as this is an intermediate heterocyst, we see that there are two sides have polar nodules. If it is a terminal heterocyst, then it will have just one polar nodule. And the heterocysts and echinates, they have a much more thicker wall than the vegetative cells. Now, reproduction. Reproduction mostly it occurs by fragmentation, and sometimes echinates, that is, these are echinates are also called arthrospores. These are perinating bodies which have size slightly larger than that of the vegetative cell. These echinates, they are used to tide over very harsh conditions. Say, for example, there is very high temperature or high aridity, or the nutrient becomes limiting, then what happens is that vegetative cell, they accumulate food matter, they increase their size, and also they not only increase their size but also the wall material around the vegetative cell. When it becomes thickened and vegetative cell increases in size, it forms echinate. So echinate are different from the vegetative cell by having a much larger size, much thicker wall, and much higher amount of nutrient material than the vegetative cells. These echinate lie dormant under unfavorable condition. On return of favorable condition, this echinate later forms a entire filament. Then is the endospore. Endospore occurs in mostly Anabina cicadae, and here in endospore, actually the vegetative cell, it is it undergoes repeated division, and many small spores are produced which are called endospores. They are produced inside the cell body of the inside the cell body, and on return of this mucilaginous wall as well as the cell wall of this cell containing the endospore, it bursts. It what happens? Let me show you. So, say for example, this is the cell. This is the normal cell, and this is the, say for example, this is the mucilaginous matrix. So what happens is that the cell content is divided repeatedly to form many small cells inside the mother cell. So this small cells, they are released when the the cell wall material, they are released when the cell wall material ruptures, and this small cells or the endospore, these small spores that are formed inside the cell, these endospore, they slip through the mucilaginous wall. They slip through the mucilaginous wall of the mucilaginous secretion of the anabina, and they come out and generate an entire filament. The entire filament of the echinete is formed from each of the endospores. Then is the heterosis. Acha, endospore is formed by, sorry, endospore, they are formed by anabina, cicadae, and sometime, very rarely, it happens that the heterocyst of anabina, it undergoes certain abnormal changes. That is, normally heterocysts are for nitrogen fixation, but under a very rare condition, heterocyst behaves like the somatic cell, and it starts dividing and produces an entire filament. So this anabina halensis forms the heterocyst. This type of behavior is also found in the nostoc, in very few species of nostoc. The ecologically, economically also, the anabina has many wide range of roles. This anabina, being a nitrogen fixer, they are used as a source of biofertilizer. If they are found to be growing in the soil, they improve the organic carbon and organic nitrogen. They increase the organic nitrogen and carbon of the soil, and anabina, it grows in symbiosis with mosquito fern, like many species of Azolla. All the species of Azolla, say for example, anabina has symbiotic relation with all the mosquito fern, that is all the Azolla, that is Azolla pinnata, Macrophylla, Azolla carolina. So what happens is that due to this symbiotic relation, this mosquito fern, they are grown in the flooded rice fields just before the cultivation of rice, and when the Azolla it dries and decomposes, the organic carbon and nitrogen that is fixed by the anabina, it is released in the soil and improves the quality of the soil. So apart from using as a biofertilizer in the Asian countries, this can also be a good source of reclamation of saline soil, because salinity, it decreases when organic carbon in the soil increases, as these they fixes what to say they not only fix nitrogen but also photosynthesize. So this cyanobacteria anabina, it's a source of both organic carbon also, so it helps in reducing the soil salinity, and also it improves the water holding capacity, because more the organic carbon and more will be the water holding capacity of the soil. And apart from that, they are the primary producer of the food chain. So this many of the in this anabina, planktonic anabina, they are fed by the zooplanktons. So this anabina, it is a food for the zooplanktons, which are again eaten by certain other invertebrates, micro invertebrates. That in this way, a complete food chain is formed. And also, one problem for this anabina is that anabina produces toxin, especially neurotoxin, hepatotoxin, and also BMAA. BMAA is a amino acid, and they actually the amount of BMAA, it is more, then they cause many metabolic problems. So, and the neurotoxins, as the name suggests, it affects the nervous system by mimicking the action of any neurotransmitter, say for example acetylcholine. Hepatotoxin, as the name suggests, it affects the liver, and so continuous exposure to this type of toxin may cause neurodegenerative disease, hepatodegenerative diseases, and apart from the azolla, anabina also forms symbiotic relationship with the bryophyte Anthoceros and the and the gymnosperm Cycas. So this is the picture where the gas vacuole in the leaf of anabina azolae. In the gas vacuole in the leaf of azolla contains anabina azolae. We know that the water fern azolla, it has to be buoyant, so they have large gas vacuoles inside their leaf, and these gas vacuoles, they are inhabited by anabina species. Now we come to the quiz section. And this neurotoxin, anatoxin A, this anatoxin A is also called very fast death factor, because apart from other type of toxins, that is the neurotoxins like mycocystin, anatoxin causes rapid death. And these anatoxins, all the toxins, they are degraded by many processes and many factors. So the question is that neurotoxin anatoxin A is degraded by which of the following factors? Acid, alkali, sunlight, or bacteria? So here the answer will be B, option B, option C, and option D. Anatoxins, they are degraded by alkaline water, the sunlight, and bacteria. With this, I come to the end of the video. If you want me to discuss something more detail about anabina, you can write it in the comment section. This anabina, this topic, both anabina, nostra, cyanobacteria, they are important from the point of view that in both BSc and MSc, short questions will be asked from this type of topics. So we should be reading the every part of this topic for the short questions. And also I have been making other videos regarding algae, lichen, and bacteria, and I have put the links in the description box. And thanks for watching the video. If you like it, share it with your friends, and do subscribe for getting the updates of the videos that I'll be making. So thank you.